Good day. Today I'm going to show you in three simple steps how to install a great little app on your RadioMaster Zorro so you may never lose your drone again, even if it loses power. It's a GPS drone tracker that'll display your drone's last location on your RadioMaster Zorro screen. It'll even display your drone's distance from you so you'll know exactly how far you'll need to go to get it. In a previous video, I described what this GPS drone tracker is and how to install it in your RadioMaster TX16S transmitter. Feel free to check that video out if you haven't seen it yet. Today, I'm just going to go over how to install the same app or widget in your RadioMaster Zorro. Of course, for this to work, you're going to need a GPS and a telemetry receiver installed and working on your drone. An Express LRS or Crossfire receiver works great. In this video, I'll be demonstrating the GPS drone tracker with an Express LRS receiver using my Express LRS RadioMaster Zorro. By the way, this exact same process I'm demonstrating also works on the RadioMaster TX12.
First thing we need to do is to go to Machado's site, the creator of this app, which I've got linked in the video description below. This site states that your transmitter needs to be on OpenTX version 2.3 or newer. However, this works on EdgeTX firmware too, as I'm demonstrating with the RadioMaster Zorro today. You'll notice down here, this GPS drone tracker works with transmitters that have different screen sizes, and there's different files for each type of screen. Since both our RadioMaster Zorro and the RadioMaster TX12 transmitters have a 128 by 64 screen size, we'll be using the files which are named for the X7 and X9 Lite. Up here, we're going to download the zip file we need, unzip the file, and inside, you'll find folders for different types of transmitters. As I just mentioned, we'll need the files in this folder. Open up the folder. For our second step, we need to copy these three files from our computer to the SD card of our RadioMaster Zorro. To access your SD card, you can either take it out of your transmitter and use an SD card to USB adapter and plug it into your computer, or turn on your RadioMaster Zorro.
Welcome to EdgeTX.
And connect it to your computer through the USB-C cable up top. I've got mine connected to a USB hub, so I'm just going to turn on a button. Select SD card storage. Open up two windows, one for your SD card drive, and the other for where you've placed your files that we need to copy over. On Windows, to open up a different window in File Explorer, you press the Windows key on your keyboard and the letter E. Now over here on the left, I've got the window where I've downloaded the three files from Machado's site. And over here on the right, I've got my SD card drive for my RadioMaster Zorro. Now we just copy this GPS.lua file from our computer over to our SD card drive under Scripts Telemetry. We also copy the Icon BMP folder over to Scripts Telemetry. And inside this folder, you've got five different BMP files. Then we copy this GPS viewer file over to Scripts Tools. We're done with step two. Now we just disconnect the Zorro from the computer, or if we've taken out the SD card, simply put it back into the transmitter. For step three, with our RadioMaster Zorro turned on, we go to our model setup menu and select our telemetry page. If you haven't already done so, to make sure you're receiving GPS telemetry, discover new sensors, then once they've loaded, stop discovery. Now we go back to our model setup menu and page back to display. We select NUMS by pressing enter. Use the scroll bar to scroll over to find scripts. Press enter. Scroll over again and press enter. Now just select the script we copied over to the SD card, GPS X9L. Press return to escape out of this menu and go back to our main model screen. From our main model screen, we simply press our telemetry button to go to our telemetry screen we just set up for our GPS drone tracker. Here we see we have the number of satellites acquired, our drone's distance from home, it's right here, our total flight distance, which is zero, it's not flying, our home GPS coordinates, and our drone's last two GPS coordinates, which you can see are updating over time. If we're flying
and our drone loses power, and I'll disconnect the battery to simulate that.
Telemetry lost.
You'll see those last GPS coordinates are still displayed on your Zorro screen. With this information saved and readily available, you just input these coordinates into Google Maps or a similar app on your phone to get directions to find your drone. Since I know you're going to have a self-powered buzzer installed on your drone similar to this VFly GPS Mate, VFly Finder buzzer, or Lucky Box buzzer, when you get in the vicinity of your drone, you should have no problem at all locating it. One more thing I want to show you. Remember we copied over those three files to our SD card and put one of them, the GPS Log Viewer, in our Scripts Tools folder? Let's go check that out. We'll return out of here. Press our Systems button. And now we're in our Tools folder. Scroll down to find your GPS Log Viewer. And press Enter. Here you can view the complete log of your flight to include the flight time, the number of satellites at that specific time, the line number of the GPS coordinates you have highlighted, and the GPS coordinates of your drone at that specific time in the flight. You may find this information useful for post-flight analysis and also locating your drone. Pretty good stuff! That's all I've got for you today. If you like the content, make sure to hit the thumbs up button below and subscribe to your TMAC FPV channel. Thanks for your time. I'll catch you next video. Clear skies, friend.